In every era of maritime history, there is always a type of ship that marks the era. In the early 20th century, giant battleships were symbols of supremacy. But since World War II, that position has been overtaken by aircraft carriers' platforms that carry not only weapons but also political, psychological, and strategic influence across oceans. The arrival of the Fujian Type 003 marks a crucial moment in that evolution. It is not simply China's third aircraft carrier, but rather a representation of Beijing's changing perspective on the sea, its power, and its role on the global stage. The Fujian is the result of decades of learning, technological accumulation, and a decades-long geopolitical vision. If the Liaoning is a symbol of learning and the Shandong a symbol of transition, then the Fujian is a declaration of maturity. This ship was not built to prove that China can, but to demonstrate that China is ready to compete at the highest levels of modern naval warfare. The construction of the Fujian at the Jiangnan shipyard in Shanghai is often viewed solely as a military project. However, it is actually a reflection of China's comprehensive national industrial transformation. An aircraft carrier is one of the most complex weapon systems ever created, combining metallurgy, electrical engineering, thermal management, software, and the coordination of thousands of components in a single floating platform. The speed and precision of the Fujian's construction demonstrate that China has passed the catch-up phase. Domestic supply chains are now capable of producing specialized steel, large power systems, and sophisticated sensors without significant external dependence. Following launch, the Fujian's sea trials were conducted in a phased and systematic manner. These tests not only assessed the ship's technical performance, but also tested the integration of man and machine, how the thousands of crew members worked together in the rhythm of real combat operations. When the Fujian was finally commissioned at the Sanya Naval Base, the strategic message was clear. The ship was being prepared not for parades, but for operational deployment. The use of the electromagnetic aircraft launch system, EMALS, is the most daring design decision in the Fujian. This technology is not simply a technical advancement, but a paradigm shift in naval aviation operations. With EMALS, the Fujian can precisely adjust launch force depending on the aircraft type. This reduces wear and tear on the aircraft structure, improves safety, and broadens the spectrum of operable air vehicles, including heavy aircraft and high-tech drones. In modern warfare, victory is often determined by tempo, how quickly aircraft can be launched, refueled, and launched again. EMALS gives the Fujian an advantage in maintaining consistent air pressure, making it a far more flexible force projection tool than older generation aircraft carriers. Furthermore, the system paves the way for the integration of future technologies that have not yet been fully implemented. The Fujian's sheer size allows for the operation of an air wing that is not only powerful but also intelligent. Its J-35 stealth fighter jets are designed to operate in environments with multiple air defenses, while its KJ-600 early warning aircraft serve as airborne command centers in the skies. This combination allows the Fujian to create what military analysts call information dominance, the ability to see further, understand faster, and act more precisely than its adversaries. The carrier no longer relies on ground sensors or external networks. It carries its own combat ecosystem, capable of operating autonomously on the high seas for extended periods. In the context of modern warfare, which relies heavily on data and networks, this capability is crucial. For decades, the Chinese Navy has focused on near-water defense. The Fujian marks a shift toward a global presence doctrine. This aircraft carrier gives China the ability to be present, defend, and operate far from national shorelines. In practice, this means the ability to protect trade routes, demonstrate security commitment, and conduct non-combat operations such as humanitarian aid and civilian evacuations. Aircraft carriers have become tools of hard diplomacy, not necessarily for war, but for influencing decisions without the need for open conflict. In modern geopolitics, presence is often as important as action. Fujian not only changes the balance of power physically, but also psychologically. Its presence forces other nations to re-examine long-held assumptions about who controls the seas and how future conflicts will unfold. In a crisis scenario, Fujian can act as a control center for joint operations, air, sea, and information. Even without direct involvement, its presence is enough to alter the calculation of risk and escalation. For the Indo-Pacific region, Fujian is a complex new variable. It adds layers of uncertainty and forces long-term strategic changes in various countries. The Fujian is proof that China now possesses nearly the entire spectrum of modern aircraft carrier technology. This independence affords significant strategic freedom both in advanced development and in responding to external pressures. Moreover, the Fujian serves as a transitional platform for the future. Integration of combat drones, artificial intelligence systems, and network-centric operations will continue to be developed on it. Many analysts believe that the experience gained from the Fujian will lay the foundation for China's next aircraft carrier, which will likely feature even more advanced technology and greater cruising range. Ultimately, the Fujian is more than just an aircraft carrier. It is a symbol of changing times, a sign that global naval power has entered a new, more competitive and multipolar phase. In the vast oceans of the 21st century, the Fujian stands as a reminder that the sea is not just a battlefield, but the central stage where the future of global geopolitics is at stake.